Yasu, I'm Catalina and I'm a visual designer. I also travel around the world practicing what I call immersive traveling. It may be a naive concept, but I believe it's possible. I'm also a freelancer working with people from around the world as a designer. And I'm an aspiring entrepreneur. Although I don't know how to code, I will learn. And you're gonna watch me do it because this is the beginning of my journey. It starts with Athens. Come here. Gypsy, I'm recording now. Immersive traveling may be a naive concept, but I believe it's an achievable experience. To me, it means that I spend enough time in an area to be part of the local culture, to really understand the lifestyle and how people see life, see happiness, love, and other core values that may be important to each of us. I stay for a month or two, creating meaningful experiences, meeting other people, meeting people that I look up to, I admire, and people that inspire me. While in Athens, I'm going to meet the founder of Dolbios.com, a very interesting service, I must say, a service that really blends with my beliefs regarding traveling. It's a website where you can book experiences with locals so that you understand what the life is in a different country from their perspective. So what I did is I went to the website, I sorted through a couple of filters and found the right match for me. I met with Michalis, who is an aspiring entrepreneur like myself. So since we were a pretty good match, I decided to book an experience with him, which was a 3-hour long walk around the center of Athens. So Dolbios basically helps you diss the tourist traps and actually get to know a country from inside out. I'm also going to meet the founders of Mama Silk Screen, Miltos and Angelina. They have started their own silk screen printing studio and they consider themselves to be poster designers. I really love meeting them because they're such a tremendous inspiration for me. I have a couple of notebooks from Mama Silkscreen Printing. They look like this and they're handcrafted. They're also printed manually. This is fluorescent ink. And the symbol on this particular notebook is a symbol of a hipster. And it is upside down because it's actually a statement that you should not be a hipster, you should just be a creative person and be yourself. I have 4 notebooks to give away and send wherever in the world you are, as long as you enter my contest once you see the interview with Mama Silkscreen. And since I am meeting young entrepreneurs, I think it was a good idea to try to meet with some of the veterans in silkscreen printing in Athens. And one of the largest silkscreen printing studios in Athens is Tin. Tin Design Studio has been in the business for a couple of decades. They're the most popular, most creative silkscreen printing studio in Greece. They are also helping young designers get out there and show their work. So it is a privilege, it's an honor to meet them, and I hope this is an inspiration for you. So I encourage you to do it. Go ahead, grow your skills, grow your talent, understand who you are, put yourself in new, very challenging situations, and do this. How do I do it? Well, there are a couple of feelings that stand at the core of a world traveler, which is a concept that is very different from a tourist. A world traveler puts traveling at the core of his life. He becomes himself through traveling because he discovers new places and people that he can interact with. He is grateful for those experiences because those are experiences that he learns from. He doesn't have dependencies like everybody else has. We depend on people to do their job, and we depend on pre-established systems to have a normal, comfortable lifestyle. When you are a world traveler, you have to depend on yourself and replace all those dependencies with trust, communication, and being genuine. So while you are a world traveler, you don't just go to different spots around the world that are popular. You actually go around the world because it's a calling for you. Because you truly appreciate meeting other people, because you value them, and because you want to keep them in your life. There are three main feelings that stand at the core of this experience, traveling around the world and working. The first and most important feeling to me is that I have nothing to lose. It really didn't start with a fun or positive story. I actually was at a point in my life where I felt everything was crumbling down, falling into pieces, and not where I was expecting those pieces to fall. And there was a switch from the feeling of profound sadness and loss to the feeling that because I have nothing to lose, I actually have everything right in front of me. This is a very empowering, very, very scary feeling. If you ever find yourself at a crossroad in your life and you don't know what to do, think of this. Maybe it is time for you to create everything that you wanted to have in your life, and it is up to you, because basically you have absolutely nothing to lose. And there's a whole world in front of you waiting to be discovered. Another core feeling that stands at the base of this experience is the feeling of respect. It's respect for the people that I meet, for the people that I work with from all these different countries. Profound respect. And that means open, direct, constructive communication, empathy, and responsibility. If you understand that respect is at the base of any kind of relationship, then you basically strip yourself off of those ego-related feelings that make you take decisions that are selfish and sometimes reckless and tough. I learned this from a person that I admire so much. He grew a company of solar panels while he was pretty young. His name is Bogdan, and I met him at a workshop. He said, if in your life you feel like you have to give up something, you need to reconsider that, because there's always a solution for everything. You don't need to break up with anybody. You don't need to give up what you love. You don't need to make any sacrifice. If that conflict arises, there's probably something wrong happening within yourself, but the solution is out there. So understand that while you go through difficulties, you never have to give up anything. And even if there are tough times and conflicts arising, do not back off. Try to understand that through respectful relationing with other people, you always find a solution to everything. And the third most important feeling that stands at the base of this experience is the feeling that you want to grow as a person. And you will do that with maturity. If you have this whimsy outlook on life, that everything should be happy and positive and just be happy all the time and that's all you want, I think you need to wake up, because pain, effort, and difficulty is part of life. While I am traveling, it's not just roses and flowers for me. It takes a lot of effort, a lot of self-management, a lot of determination, a lot of belief that I am doing something that is meaningful beyond my personal happiness and satisfaction. If you're only following personal happiness and satisfaction, you probably have to be a very, very egocentric person. But if you get rid of that selfishness and learn to give in order to receive, you will discover life in such a more wonderful light and darkness. So these are the three basic feelings that stand at the base of my experience of traveling around the world, and I want to know, what are your feelings? Do share. Thank you. Live, love, and have a purpose. This is the meeting of freedom, so be free. Peace.